video games from the 80s are crazy. I love how they can take something like a job and present it in such an abstract and action-packed way that they make said occupation seem fun. And there's no better example of this than Taito's 1982 arcade game, Zookeeper. In Zookeeper, you play as Zeke, a man out with a mission to build a wall to keep all the animals from escaping their tiny and terribly made cages. I want to make a joke about building walls and our current president, but I won't. Because even alluding to that kind of makes me feel dirty. Besides, Zeke is way more likable than Donald Trump, even if he kind of looks like a bootleg Mario. With each level, the game introduces a new animal, with each being faster and stronger than the last one. This includes elephants, snakes.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
Camels, rhinos, moose, and finally lions. Wait a second. Are you telling me that in this game, a moose is a bigger threat than a rhino? That seems hard to believe to me. Now, I'm not devaluing the ugly Canadian cousin to the deer. They can fuck you up. True that. But fuck you up more than a rhino? I don't think so. However, in this game, they sure aren't lying. Because these aren't your mom's Bullwinkle J moose. They can take down a brick wall like it's frickin' nothing. This is the scariest moose I've ever seen since that one episode of Invader Zim. Speaking of which, I hate the fact that the plural for moose is moose. It just doesn't sound right. Like, if I say that's a bunch of moose, it sounds less like I saw a group of them, and more like I saw a single moose that was really, really fat. Can we officially change the plural to moose to meese? Because in this game, I hate meeses to pieces. Oh boy, man, did I really get off topic there. Anyways, let's get to the gameplay. This game actually has three completely different gameplay styles, which is pretty unique for a game in 1982. The main game has this cage in the center of the screen with animals continuing to escape from it. Zeke has to reinforce it by building a wall around the cage. He does this by running left and right in a square formation. And man, Zeke can build fast enough to give Fix-It Felix a run for his money. Felix might be able to fix it, but Zeke can build it. There's a depleting bar at the top of the screen that works as the game's timer. This signifies how long Zeke gets to build a wall before, well, time runs out. Once the timer ends, you're given points for every animal that you manage to keep behind the wall. However, be careful. When an animal escapes, and they will, the animal will kill you with a mere touch, causing you to lose a life. Fortunately, Zeke can also jump to avoid these escaped enemies. Best of all, Zeke cannot just jump far, but he can also change his direction easily in mid-jump. This is pretty impressive for such an old game, since most games of this age, once you jump, you're 100% committed to it. There is no changing it. But here, Zeke can move all left and right while jumping, and it gives you a surprising amount of control. And it feels really fluid and natural, too. Now, back to the bar on the top of the screen. You will notice that there's also food items and a net on it as well. If the meter hits one of these, they will appear on the screen for Zeke to collect. Food items will just score you points, but the net is Zeke's version of a power pellet. Zeke will noticeably start waving the net around while the background changes from black to blue. During this temporary mode, any animal Zeke touch will be sent back to the cage in the center of the screen, granting you a better chance to net a higher score at the end of the level. After you finish two of these wall-building levels, you'll go to a platforming level where a monkey seems to have kidnapped Zeke's girlfriend Zelda, and you have to jump on floating platforms to get to her while dodging gravity-defying coconuts thrown by the monkey. Sometimes there's so many coconuts on this screen it feels like a damn bullet hail shooter. Hey, wait, his girlfriend's name is Zelda? Watch out, Link! Looks like Zeke is moving in on your territory.
Well, excuse me, princess.
Once you get to Zelda, whoa! Yeah, I know, it's a graphical glitch, but when I first saw this, I actually thought things got a little crazy. Later, you're also given another gameplay style that's kind of like a mix between the previous two. Now you're jumping over escaped animals and cages while climbing escalators to save your lady love once again. Do this enough times and things will get so frisky that Zelda will have to censor it for all the impressionable children playing this game. Man, look at all them hearts. And that's the three gameplay styles that are in the game, which makes it a pretty versatile game for its time. The best part about the game is the controls. They're very fluid. It causes the gameplay to feel very fair and forgiving. No matter how hectic things got, I never felt like the game was being cheap or unfair. I always felt like I was the one at fault. And again, that's pretty impressive for an arcade machine made specifically to take your quarters. To give an example of how impressively forgiving this game is, if you die at the first animal, the game will actually give you a do-over and not even take a life. This is seriously the nicest thing I've ever seen an arcade game do. Overall, Zookeeper is a simple, fun, frantic, and highly addictive game that has an impressive amount of variety for its time. I highly recommend giving this one a try. So much so, I'm willing to give this game a 5 out of 5 Mises. This is a really amazing title that is sadly overlooked among a majority of other classic video games from the era. In fact, the only port I know of it was on Taito Legends Collection for PS2, and that was just a straight emulation. Regardless, give it a try. This one is definitely a keeper.